Hi everyone, welcome to the Real Estate Tax Tips channel. My name is Cherry Chen, a chartered professional accountant located in Oakville, Ontario, Canada. And I'm on a mission to become the Google Map for hardworking Canadians seeking financial freedom. And today's topic is about moving expenses. As you all know, a lot of us and a lot of hardworking Canadians, as a result of pandemic and all these work from home order required by the government, move from one city to another because they want to enjoy the green space, the bigger space, rather than being stuck in a tiny small condo in the city. And a lot of people incur quite a bit of moving expenses. And in certain circumstances, you are actually eligible to claim moving expenses as a deduction on your personal tax return. So today we're going to dive deeper into what kind of moving expenses are qualified and how you can qualify to deduct moving expenses on your personal tax returns. Now, before I get too much into depth, every week I send out an email about money saving tips and real estate tax tips, all designed to help you build your long-term wealth and live life on your terms. The email takes 5 minutes to read and over 10,000 Canadians get it. Think you'll like it. Sign up using the link below. So are moving expenses tax deductible? Did you move in 2021 or 2022, or are you planning to move in the next few years? During the pandemic, a large number of Canadians have moved from the cities to the suburbs, trying to find more space in and out of their homes. As it turns out, the few thousand dollars of moving expenses that you spend could potentially be tax deductible, provided that you meet certain criteria. In some cases, you might even be able to deduct the realtor expenses you incur to sell your old homes. Wow, that's quite a bit of a deduction. According to the CRA, you can generally claim moving expenses you pay in the year from the employment or self-employment income you earned at your new work location, provided that you meet both of these two criteria. To claim tax deductible moving expenses, 1. You must have moved to work or run a business at a new location. 2. Your new home must be at least 40 kilometers closer by the shortest public commute to your new work location. So let's use an example to explain. Coincidentally, I moved in 2021. I moved in 2021 from Burlington to Oakville so that I could have a shorter commute to the office, to my office space. The drive from my old house to the office location was only 20 kilometers. The drive from my new house to my office is 11 kilometers. My new home is only 9 kilometers closer to my office. Therefore, I would not be qualified to claim any moving expenses because the requirement is that I have to be living for at least 40 kilometers closer to my office to allow me to deduct my moving expenses. Now, let's use another example to explain. You got a new job in Kitchener, where you grew up. Your old job was in Toronto and you lived close by. With the new job, you decided to move back to Kitchener. It will only take you 10 kilometers drive to your new job. If you were to stay in Toronto, the commute each way would have been 120 kilometers. You're closer to your new work location by about 110 kilometers. Therefore, it's easy to understand that you're eligible to deduct the moving expenses on your personal tax return against your income. Now that you know the criteria to deduct moving expenses, let's discuss the type of moving expenses that are possible, eligible for deduction. Tax deductible moving expenses include transportation and storage costs. And transportation and storage costs includes packing, hauling, movers, in transit storage, and insurance for household items. Second type of expense that you can deduct is the travel expense, vehicle expense, meals and accommodation to move you and your household members, your families, to the new home. The third type of expense is the temporary living expenses for a maximum of 15 days that includes meals and temporary lodging near the old and the new home for you and your household members that you temporarily live in to wait for the new place to be ready. The fourth type is the cost of canceling your lease for your old home. Deductible expenses would include the forfeiture of your last month rent, any costs you incur to cancel the lease, but not your regular rental payments before you move. The fifth item that you could deduct is the incidental costs that you incur for your move. For example, changing your address on legal documents, replacing driver licenses and non-commercial vehicle permits, not including insurance, and also utility hookups and disconnection charges. These expenses are all tax deductible. Now, the sixth item that could also be tax deductible is the cost to maintain your old home when vacant after you moved out and during a period when you try to sell the home. Now, the type of expenses that you can deduct that's incurred in your old home include interest expense, property taxes, insurance premium, and the cost of heating and utilities expense. You can have a deduction as much as $5,000. However, you cannot claim these costs during a period when the old home was rented. This means that these costs must have been incurred when your old home was vacant. Number seven, cost of selling your old home. Cost of selling your own home can also be a tax deduction as a moving expense under your personal income tax return. And the cost of selling your old home can be a substantial amount of deduction. These expenses can be related to advertising, notary or legal fees, real estate commissions, mortgage penalty when the mortgage is paid off before maturity. So it could encompass a large variety of expense and it is all tax deductible, provided that you meet the criteria as I mentioned earlier. Now, the last type of expense that could be tax deductible is the cost of buying the new home. The cost of buying your new home can also be tax deductible. This includes the legal fees you pay to purchase your new home, as well as any taxes that you pay for the transfer or registration of title to the new home. As Canadian taxpayers, we all need to earn our deduction. This means that you would be required to provide documentation and receipts for all the expenses deducted to prove your deduction. If you don't have any receipts, unfortunately, you aren't eligible for any deduction for the expense. Even if you have all the receipts, there are some exceptions to the deductions. Here are a few examples that's not part of the deductible expense. This includes the renovation done to make your old home more sellable. Any loss that you incur for the sale of your old home would not be tax deductible. Travel expenses for house hunting trips, unfortunately, it's not tax deductible. Travel expenses for job hunting in another city, not tax deductible. The value of the items movers refuse to take, such as the plans, frozen food, the items that you lost, those are not tax deductible expenses. And expenses to clean or repair a rented home to meet the landlord standard is also not tax deductible. Expenses to replace personal use items such as tools, sheds, firewood, drapes, and carpets, not tax deductible. Cost of transformers or adapters for household appliances, costs incurred in the sale of your old home, if you delay selling for investment purposes, or until the real estate market picked up, those are not tax deductible. Mortgage default insurance, not tax deductible. Eligible expenses for which you do not have the required supporting documentation, again, not tax deductible. Now that you know what can be deductible and the amount of deduction could be substantial, what is the catch? The catch here is that you could only take a deduction against your new job income. The maximum amount you can deduct as moving expenses is capped by the amount of income you are getting from your new job or new self-employment income. You cannot use the moving expenses to deduct against investment income or other sources of income. But don't worry though, if your moving expenses are greater than the eligible income that you can deduct against, the extra amount that's not deducted in the current year can be carried forward to future years for further deduction. If you receive any reimbursement from your employers for the move, you will have to report the reimbursement as income, offsetting against the net moving expenses for the deduction. And what if your tax deductible moving expense incur in the year after your move? Let's say you move to your new residence that's closer to your new workplace by 40 kilometers at least, close to the year end, and you have incurred a portion of the moving expense in the year after the move. You can then claim these expenses that you incur in the future year on the return for the year you pay them against your employment income earned at the new work location. So the same rule applies if you sold your old home after the year of your move. In this situation, the CLA may ask you to submit a form with receipts and explain the delay in selling your home. But bear in mind that you cannot carry back moving expenses to a prior year. You can carry them forward to future years, provided that you are eligible. Now that we have discussed all the ins and outs of deducting moving expenses, including the criteria, the type of expenses that are tax deductible, the type of expenses that are not tax deductible, the catch of deducting moving expenses, and the carry forward rules available for deducting moving expenses. If you like this video, make sure that you hit the thumbs up button at the below this video. If you want to stay on top of the latest tax tips, make sure you hit the little subscribe button below and turn on the little notification button. Until next time, happy Canadian real estate investing!